Hi, I'm Zach, and welcome to Poster Fix.
Today you're going to see me linenback and touch up two vintage posters, very glossy, for the guitarist John 5. This one is in pretty good condition, but...
And here's another John 5 poster. This one's in rougher condition. It had a lot of ripples in it. As you can see, there are these lines here. So this is getting put on an archival linen back. Oh, and here is a Blade Runner poster that has been autographed by everybody. And here's a Rosemary's Baby poster. This too is in a similar condition. It was rolled up and it got dinged and banged around. Similar kind of damage, although there's less of it. This one's in very good shape. It was also rolled and there are dings in it, suggesting that one time it was crushed in the past, but that's all. Other than that, it looks fine.
So these John 5 posters have been linen-backed to this screen, along with other posters. We're going to let this screen dry for a few days before we trim them down and commence with the color restoration. You won't want to miss that, so don't go away. On a future episode of Poster Fix, watch us linenback this Street Fighter poster, also this Goleon poster, and more, plus a very special uncut sheet of Bazooka Joe.
Have you ever heard of Bazooka Joe?
We're back in the Poster Fix shop. Several days have passed. The posters are dry. I've cut them down off the stretcher screen, and now I'm cutting the edges to make them straight before commencing with the color retouching, which is what I'm going to do next.
The orange-green one needs a lot more touch-up than the blue one.
The horizontal lines, the damage, is caused by this poster having been rolled for many, many years and then being scrunched or sat on or crushed several times at different times in history. And now I'm finding it hard to choose what kind of media I should use to do this color retouching, this in-painting as it were. I'm tempted to combine both watercolor markers and watercolor pencils to try to get it correct and also to try to recreate the gloss that was there before. I have to say that this glossy poster is one of the most difficult posters to touch up I've ever had to do of this kind. I'm finding it very hard to get an accurate color without combining different colors against each other, glazing one over another, and then the matter of recreating the gloss. To do the touch-up on this John 5 poster, I'm going to employ any kind of technique that I think will work. Basically, I want to use water-reversible markers, water-reversible pencils, and even gouache if I need to, and a lot of spit and polish and a lot of fudging here and there. Basically, this is an art form, and I'm going to treat it as such. John 5. John William Lowery was born in 1971, and he's best known by the stage name John 5. And he is an American guitarist. His stage name was bestowed on him in 1998 when he left David Lee Roth's solo band and joined the rock group Marilyn Manson as their guitarist, taking over for Zim Zum. Still going by the name John 5, Lowery has since become the guitarist for Rob Zombie.
Now this John 5 poster doesn't need as much. It's got some mix in it here, right? Some mix here from one bang that occurred while it was rolled.
He is also a solo artist, having recorded 10 guitar albums. Vertigo in 2004, Songs for Sanity, 2005, The Devil Knows My Name, 2007, Requiem, 2008, The Art of Malice in 2010, God Told Me To in 2012, Careful With That Axe, 2014, Season of the Witch in 2017, Invasion 2019, Sinner in 2021. He also has a remix album, Remixploitation from 2009, and live albums. And he's very prolific.
Well, this brings us to the end of Poster School. I thank you for joining me today, and hope you'll come again next time. Thank you.